everybody. For those who don't know, I'm running this regular column. It's Person of the Month. My goal is to introduce you to the important names in our community. The first one I did was about Guido van Rossum, the creator of the language, to put a face on a name so that you can maybe meet with these people, you can connect during PyCon, or you can just know who they are, why they are doing this in Python, what's their motivation, and maybe they can inspire you to be involved in projects and have fun. Today I selected Lynn Root because I'm switching between Canadian people and international people. Here are a few logos of the things she's involved with, which I'm going to detail a little. So Lynn Root is mostly known as the founder of PyLAD San Francisco. And the interesting thing about her is that she's a new Python programmer. Academic formation is a bachelor in finance. And she started a course of computer science in 2011, but she failed. It was a Harvard course, and she did not complete it. But during a hackathon, she actually discovered Python, and she understood everything, and then she fell in love. And that was the start of her journey. So you can see in 2 years, she's a well-known figure of the community, doing lots of interesting stuff. And she did not start with a formal education or complicated computer science, she just jumped in. An interesting thing is that she joined Women Who Code, which is an organization devoted to teaching programming to women. And she actually became co-organizers right at the start. And a year later, she founded PyLAD San Francisco. I think most people know about PyLAD. If you don't, you're welcome to look at the website or talk I did a few months ago. It's an international support and mentoring group for women in Python. And you can see just a year after starting Python, she gave a talk at EuroPython, then PyCon US, PyCon Canada, PyCon US again. And she works at Red Hat on something called FreeIPA, which is an identity management integrated solution. She's also a member of the Python Software Foundation and the Django Software Foundation, which shows that this organization and the community in general help people who help the community become more diverse and supportive. If you go to speakerdeck.com on her profile, it's linked from her website. I give the link at the end. You can see how she started. Right after she learns something, she starts teaching it. And it's true about Python, but also about communities. Like, she's doing talks about how you can teach Python, but also how you can build communities to teach Python. And the key, some of her key insights is that to get more women and more people from all kinds into Python, the big problems are confidence. Like, maybe many of you think you're not qualified enough to submit a talk to PyCon, but actually you should. That's why we have PyLAD this group, so that women who wouldn't have confidence maybe to speak in front of a regular crowd, which is mostly male, can have a space free of judgment to talk. It's also about being inclusive, which is why the Python Software Foundation makes effort to foster diversity. And it's building the community. We're not just building code, we're building community. I think we're all living this here. A project I like to highlight from Lynn is a New Coder. It's a website called newcoder.io. And it comes, again, from a problem she found, something she wanted to do. And when she learned it, she taught it. So it's a website where you can find tutorial. When you're completed, or when a friend of you has completed the basic talks, you can like dive into Python or learn Python the hard way, all the basic tutorials on the web. OK, no, I know the basics. Maybe you have something you want to solve, but you're not finding like the middle ground tutorials. Or maybe you have no ideas of how you can further your learning. If you go to New Coder, you have concrete tutorials about using the Twitter API, data visualization, stuff like that, so that you can find your next project to go from novice to middle or advanced Python programmer. Lynn loves the documentation culture of the Python community. Everything's documented, and if it's not, we complain about it, and we try to fix it. And with this project, she solved a part of this problem. It's also an open community and an open website. We should translate it into French. We should add tutorials. We can all contribute using GitHub. I'm leaving you. Yeah, that's a part of our talk. Again, go to speaker deck and look at the slide. It's really insightful if you're interested about teaching her insights. So I'm leaving you with a quote. You can read it for yourself. And some links. This is going to be online, so you can check everything out. Thank you.